नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय टुडे दिस मॉर्निंग वी विल बी रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कांटो 8 चैप्टर 5 एंटाइटल्ड द डेमी गॉड अपील टू द लॉर्ड एंड टेक्स्ट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू read 27 please repeat after me vipassitam prana mano dhyatmanam vipassitam prana mano dhyatmanam arthe indriya bhasam anindram abranam छाया तपो यत्र न गृद्ध पक्षो तमक्षरं खं त्रिजुगं व्रजामहे विपक्षितां अन्टु द ओम्निसेंट प्राणा हाउ द लिविंग force is working manaha how the mind is working dhiya how the intelligence is working atmana of all living entities artha the object of the senses Indriya, the senses. Abhasam, knowledge. Anidram, always awake and free from ignorance. Abranam, without a material body subject to pain and pleasure. छाया आतप द शेल्टर फॉर ऑल हु आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम इग्नोरेंस यत्र वेयर इन नॉट गृध्र पक्ष पार्शियलिटी टुवर्ड्स एनी लिविंग बीइंग ताम अंटु हिम अब सॉरी अक्षरम इनफालिबुल खम ऑल परवेडिंग लाइक द स्काई त्रिजुगम अपीयर्ड विथ सिक्स ऑपुलेंसेस इन थ्री युगा सत्य त्रेता एंड द्वापर व्रजामहे आई टेक शेल्टर ट्रांसलेशन एंड परपट बाय श्रील प्रभुपाद जय श्रील प्रभुपाद की ट्रांसलेशन द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉड हेड डायरेक्टली एंड इनडायरेक्टली नोज हाउ एवरीथिंग इंक्लूडिंग द लिविंग फोर्स माइंड and intelligence is working under his control. He is the illuminator of everything and has no ignorance. He does not have a material body subject to reaction of previous activities and he is free from ignorance of partiality and materialistic education. I therefore take shelter of the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord, who is eternal, all-pervading, and as great as the sky, and who appears with three opulences, in three yuga, Satya, Treta and Dwapara, Purport. In the beginning of Srimad Bhagavatam, the Supreme Personality of Godhead is described in this way. Janma desyatonvayaditartascharthesvabhigya. The Lord is the origin of all emanation, and He directly and indirectly knows everything about all activities within this creation. Therefore, the Lord is addressed here as Vipaschitam, one who is full of all knowledge or who knows everything. The Lord is the Super Soul, and He knows everything about the living entities and their senses. The word Anidram, meaning always awake and free from ignorance, is very important in this verse. As stated in Bhagavad Gita, Mattah Smritir Jnanam Apohanam Cha, it is the Lord who gives intelligence to everyone and who causes everyone to forget. There are millions and millions of living entities, and the Lord gives them direction. Therefore, He has no time to sleep, and He is never in ignorance of our activities. The Lord is the witness of everything. He sees what we are doing at every moment. The Lord is not covered by the body resulting from the karma. Our bodies are formed as a result of our past deeds, karmana daiva netrena. But the Supreme Personality of Godhead does not have a material body, and therefore He has no avidya, ignorance. He does not sleep, but is always alert and awake. The Supreme Lord is described as Tri-Yuga because although He appeared variously in Satya-Yuga, Treta-Yuga and Dwapar-Yuga, when He appeared in Kali-Yuga, He never declared Himself the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Krishna-Varnam Tisha-Krishnam Sango-Pangastra-Parsadam. The Lord appears in Kali-Yuga as a devotee. Thus, although He is Krishna, He chants the Hare Krishna Mahamantra like a devotee. Still, Srimad Bhagavatam 11.5.32 recommends Yajna Sankirtana Prayar Yajanti Hi Sumedhasa. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, whose complexion is not black like that of Krishna, but is golden, Tisha Akrishnam, is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is accompanied by associates like Nityananda, Advaita, Gadadhar, Srivas. Those who are sufficiently intelligent worship this Supreme Personality of Godhead by performing Sankirtana Yajna. In this incarnation, the Supreme Lord declares Himself not to be the Supreme Lord, and therefore He is known as Tri-Yuga. Vipaschitam Prad Mano Dhyat Manam Artha Indriya Bhasam Anindrama Branam Chaya Tapo Na Yatra Griddh Pakshav Tamaksharam Kham Tribhuvam Tri-Yugam Brajamahe. This verse, Lord Brahma offering offerings, offering prayer on behalf of all living entities, all demigods. So we will come to the point how come what Brahma says in this verse. That is a break background. How this situation came that Brahma offer offerings, offering prayers. We know the 8th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, it is described about Manvantara. We know in Srimad Bhagavatam, in beginning of, almost in the beginning of Srimad Bhagavatam, it described that in Srimad Bhagavatam there are 10 subject matter as described. 10 subject. Out of 10 subject matter, one is Manvantara, Manu. In there are 14 Manu, and one Manu rules the universe for 71 Chaturyuga. And in order to please, in order to maintain Manu Maharaj, once Lord appears in the duration of Manu, that called Manvantara Avatar. So while Sukadev Goswami was describing about Manvantara, he was talking about 6th Manvantara. We are living in 7th Manvantara, this is. The 6th Manvantara, in 6th Manvantara, Lord appeared as Ajit. In 6th Manvantara, Lord appeared and his name was Ajit. And his father's name was Vairaj and mother was Dev Sambhuti. Vairaj in the womb of his wife, Dev Sambhuti begot a son. Son was the original Supreme Personality of Godhead and his name was Ajit. Sukadev Goswami was describing himself. And in this particular incarnation, Lord Ajit Krishna produced by churning the ocean of milk, Kshir Sagar, by churning Kshir Sagar, Lord produced Amrit nectar for demigods. Other things were also produced. The most prominent, important thing were produced by churning Samudra, Kshir Sagar, that's Amrit, and it was produced for the demigod. This much Sukadeva Goswami described. Then Parikshit Maharaj inquired, asked question, how Krishna, Vishnu, Ajit churn this ocean of milk, Samudra, Kshir Sagar, and for what reason? What was the reason for churning? And then Sukadev Goswami described how come that Lord has to churn the Kshir Sagar. For that Sukadev Goswami described the reason why Kshir Sagar was churned and nectar was produced. So he retells story part. Story he starts, once upon a time, Durvasa Rishi was walking, traveling in middle of forest. And in middle of forest, he saw Lord Indra, the king of heaven, was coming from opposite direction. He was coming. Immediately, Durvasa Rishi, being such a mystic yogi and devotee of Krishna, he had one very garland, very glorious garland, is a prasad, garland prasadam. So out of intense compassion, he is king of heaven, Indra. So Durvasa Rishi took that garland from his neck, and he offered to Indra. This was his mercy, this prasadam, garland prasadam, he offered Indra. You Indra, this is for you. This directly it is coming from offering from the Krishna. Indra took the garland. He did not appreciate, he did not show any respect for the prasadam garland. Garland prasadam. Immediately he threw that garland on the top of his arrow, elephant.
the top of his head.
He did not like, he did not give any respect for the garland. And then being an animal, if the king failed to appreciate the greatness of garland, what to speak of elephant? Elephant immediately took with his trunk, garland was resting, sitting on the head of Airavat. Airavat took with his trunk and threw on the ground. And he walked in the same direction, he crushed, trampled the garland. And all this happened right in front of Durvasa Rishi. Durvasa Rishi known for, you know, he becomes very, in slight some discrepancy, becomes angry. And this was sufficient karan, or say more than sufficient karan to be angry. Such a respect, disrespect for prasadam. Immediately Durvasa Rishi altered a course. You Indra, such intoxicated, you did not appreciate the greatness of garland, purity of garland you threw here, I curse you. You become bereft of all your auspiciousness, all your opulence, not only you, all your associate as well, they will be become bereft of all opulences. This is Durvasa Rishi. You know, we become intoxicated. Generally, people become intoxicated. What could be reason for intoxication? How we become intoxicated? Usually, some wine or sarab, liquor you consume or drink, then you become intoxicated. So certainly Indra has not consumed any liquor or varuni, and Durvasa Rishi were intoxicated. He was intoxicated by his opulence. In a Hindi poet talks about intoxication. The wine, certainly it intoxicating, but opulence reaches, he says, gold is more intoxicating. Gold has more intoxicating potency than wine, liquor. Kanak kanak te sau guna madakta adhikai. Kanak means a certain type of herb, it is offered on Shivlinga to Shiva, that is called dhatura. Very intoxicating. If you crush a few, simply you take few seed from the dhatura and put your mouth, crush, immediately you become intoxicated. That is a kanak. But this poet says that this kanak, kanak means gold. Gold has more intoxicating potency than this liquor or kanak, dhatura. 100 times more potency. How? When you eat dhatura, kanak, or when you consume wine, then you become intoxicated. But see the potency of kanak, gold. If it simply enters in your pocket, you become intoxicated. Or if gold enters in your bank account, you need now to eat the, in order to become intoxicated, you need now to eat consumed gold. Just it came in your house, in presence of your, immediately we become intoxicated. So Indra was intoxicated, not that he has consumed some liquor, he had, due to his opulence. So he was cursed. By the curse of Durvasa Rishi, immediately all demigod, Indra including all demigod, they become poverty stricken. They lose all their beauty, their influence, their riches also, everything. And when the demigod saw this awkward position of demigod, immediately they attacked. And the whole heavenly planet, it was invaded by demons. So they, Indra, everyone become bereft of opulences. Then all demigod assembled together, but they could not find any solution. So all demigod, they went to Lord Brahma. They approached Lord Brahma and talked to Brahma that this is our awkward position, we are in such a suffering condition. And then Brahma took them, all the demigod, and he went to Swetdeep. Swetdeep is the abode of Lord Vishnu. Brahma went there and Brahma started offering offerings, prayers, offer prayer. So this is the second verse, Brahma praising, glorifying the Vishnu Lord. First verse, it is Namamahe Deva Varam Varanyam. May the Supreme Personality of Godhead, we offer our humble offerings on the your lotus feet. And in this particular verse, he said, Trijugam Brajamahe, we are taking shelter unto your lotus feet. First was offering offerings, and second verse talks about Brajamahe, we are in your sharan, we are in your shelter, we have come in your, please protect me. So while describing, he, Brahmaji, talking about some transcendental quality of Lord Vishnu, one thing, Vipaschitam. Vipaschitam means, Lord, you know everything, or omniscient, you know everything. In Bhagavad Gita, one verse, Krishna says, Vedaham samti tani, vartmanani charjuna, bhavishyani cha bhutana, mam tu vedana kasyanam. Vedaham samti tani. I know everything, what had happened already in past. Everything I know. And vartmanani charjuna, what is happening in present, I know everything. Bhavishyani cha bhutanam, and anything is yet to happen, I know everything. But unfortunately, mam tu vedana kasana. Nobody knows me, I know everything. So here Brahma vipaschitam, my dear Lord, you are omniscient, you are sarvagya, you know everything. Prad mano dhyatmanam arthe indriya bhasa manidram. How our living force, prana, is working. How our mind, what thought is coming in your mind, our mind. How mind is working and how intelligence is working. You know everything. You are vipaschit. You are sarvagya. You are omniscient. Arthendriya bhasmanidbharam. And also Brahma says, due to your mercy, due to your mercy, we are able to see anything. In your indriya, our senses has some ability to see something or know something, conceive something. It is due to your mercy, your potency. And same time, the senses, you have provided energy or potency for senses. And same time, you illuminate, you are illuminated of sense object. And he said, you have no any material body, you have transcendental body, Sachidananda Swarup. Chaya tapo na yatra kritam. And your personality, there is no partiality at all. There is no ignorance. Tamak sharam kham. You are infallible. You are kham. Kham means sky. You are as great as a sky itself. All pervading personality, we are Trijugam Brajamahe. You are Trijuga. Srila Prabhupada in this purpose talks about many things about Trijugam. One name of Krishna is Trijuga. Trijug means one who appears in three yuga. Krishna appeared only in three yuga, Satyayug, Treta and Dwapar. Krishna never ever appear in Kali Yug. That is reason why one name of Krishna is Trijugam here. Trijugam Namamahe. You appear in three different ages. Three different Satyayug, Treta and Dwapar. So far as Kali is concerned, you usually don't appear. You appeared in the form of your name. Kali Kale Nam Rupe Krishna Avatar. Krishna also appears in this age of Kali also. But not as a Supreme Personality of Godhead, you appeared Kali Kale Nam Rupe Krishna Avatar. Krishna appears certainly, but in the Nam Rup, in the form of His holy name. So Brahmaji said, you are Trijugam. The word says Trijugam. You are appear only. So how come Brahma? Brahmaji, pagal ho gaye hain kya? You don't know that Krishna appeared just 500 years ago in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Swayam Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna, appeared in the Kali Yuga as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Brahma. You are pagal ho gaye ho. You say that Krishna is Trijugam Namam hai, only three yuga. Prabhupada in purport clarify this point. And Prabhupada also talked when Gargacharya ji, you know, Krishna appeared in Mathura and same night he was transferred in the Gokul. When Krishna age was approximately 100 days, little more than 3 months, Gargacharya came and Gargacharya Nanda Baba together they performed the name giving ceremony of Krishna. At that time Gargacharya uttered very important celebrated verse. Asan Varnashtrayo Yasya. My dear Nanda Baba, your son, blackish one, he has, apart from this blackish color, now he is black, but apart from this blackish color, asan varnashtrayo hi asya, your boy, your child, your baby, previously he has assumed three different colors. Suklo raktas tatha pitam. In Satyayug also he took birth. Your son, now he has become your son, but your son took birth in Satyayug. And then in Satyayug, his color, he assumed a color or complexion of white. And in next millennium, next yuga, means Treta Yug, Raktas, red. And in other yuga, I mean Kali Yuga, Pita, he assumes, he appeared and his complexion becomes yellowish. Idanim Krishna Tam Gata. And now he has assumed, he has taken the color, complexion of Krishna. So Pita, Krishna, your child appears in Kali Yuga in yellowish complexion. Certainly that is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But Brahmaji, such a authority, he could not make any mistake. Krishna appeared, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared in Kali Yuga. Swayam, Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna appeared as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. There is no difference between Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Krishna and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was here, appeared, though he was Supreme Personality of Godhead, and many exalted personalities, they could, Krishna was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu hiding himself, so much so that if some devotee, because Rupa Goswami, or they could, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu could not hide himself by pure devotee. And when they were telling that you are Supreme Personality of God, immediately Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would block his ear with his hand and says, Vishnu, Vishnu, what offense you are? A ordinary human being should not be called Supreme Personality of Vishnu. It is offense. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never accepted that he is Supreme Personality of Godhead. Though he was Supreme Personality of God, he was trying to hide. Though he was Supreme Personality of Godhead, but he was playing a role of a pure devotee. So this was a hidden incarnation. That is the reason why, knowing my mentality or purpose of Krishna, because when he comes in Kali Yuga, then he doesn't declare himself, I am Supreme Personality of Godhead. When Krishna said frankly in front of, when big, I am Supreme Personality of Godhead. Matta smritir gyan, everything, I control everything. Maya dhakshina prakriti suyate sacharacharam. But when same Krishna came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he never accept. So that is the reason why name of Vishnu, Krishna, is Trijugam. Though he appeared in all four yugas. In Kali Yuga, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared, Krishna appeared, and he accepted the complex, yellowish complexion. And other, he in this Prabhupada has quoted that Trijugam. Yugam means pair, three pairs. Krishna has six opulences, you know. Jante na? Gyan, the six of Gyan, Bal, Yash, Saundar, Dhan and Vairagya. Knowledge, strength, reputation, Saundar, beauty, Dhan and Vairagya. So these six, the Prabhupada here talks about three pairs. What is Gyan and Bal? Gyan and Bal. Out of six opulence, you took Gyan and Bal. This is one pair. Yash and Saundar, second pair. And Dhan and Vairagya, third pair. The three yuga. Krishna has all, full of all six opulences, and it is in three pairs, two, three times. So that is all, the Trijugam Namamahat. So here, Brahmaji saying, offering offerings on behalf of all demigods, and he is mentioning about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also. So this is simple prayer. Today is also Disappearance Day, our three Goswami. So few minutes I have, we will try to discuss something. So I have to be brief. Let us talk about Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. There is no, not any anonymous opinion about his appearance. Many, some people say that he appeared in 1496, some people said 1496, but many people say that no, he appeared in 1517, and he disappeared 1616 or 17, almost 100 years. Another opinion is that he appeared in 1520 and disappeared in 1616 or 1617, almost that is 100 years. He appeared in the district of Bardhaman. If you have opportunity to go Mayapur by train, one very important railway station comes Bardhaman, and many people get down from the train and the state goes to Mayapur. It is nearer and cheaper also if you go by taxi or bus. So he appeared and disappeared in Vrindavan, Braj area. And he has some disagreement with his younger brother, Shyam Das. For that reason, he left his house, home, and came to Vrindavan. And while he was on the way to Vrindavan, he came out from the house, his residence. Then Nityananda Prabhu appeared in his dream. And directly Nityananda Prabhu in a dream directed him, you go to Vrindavan. Jaya Jaya Nityananda Nityananda Ram Jahara Kripate Painu Vrindavana Dham. Krishnadas Kaviraj. Jaya Jaya Nityananda Nityananda Ram Jahara Kripate. By your mercy Nityananda, I got opportunity, I got a residence in Vrindavan. So he came in Vrindavan, and on the bank of, he was in Braj area, but mostly Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami lived in Radhakund. More than 40 years he spent right in Radhakund, on the bank of Radhakund and Shyamkund, and that is the place where he compiled two most glorious important books. One about Chaitanya Charitamrita, and it is in Bangla language, and another book he compiled, Govinda Lila Mritam, Ashtayam Lila of Radha and Krishna. Ashtayam Lila, that details Ashtayam Lila, that is Sanskrit, the two books, Chaitanya Charitamrita and Govinda Lila Mrita, the two very glorious book is compiled by Krishnadas Kaviraj. And today is his disappearance. Such a very humble person he was, one of the most confidential associates of Sadh Goswami, especially Raghunath Das Goswami. But he was such a humble, he was Jagai Madhai Haite Moise Papist. He said, I am more sinful than Jagai and Madhai. And Puri se rakit haite mui se lagi. I am more lower than the worm residing in the stool. Not only that, one place he said, more naam sune jai tar puni chhoi. If someone by mistakes hears my name, Krishnadas Kaviraj, this his name enters in the ear, immediately Puna Kshaya, whatever piety you have earned, immediately eradicate, finish. Simply hear Krishnadas Kaviraj say, if you hear Krishnadas Kaviraj, is the word entered into your, immediately all your pious credit earned in millions of immediately eradicated. Finished. And more naam loj, and by mistake someone utters my name, then all sinful reaction comes in his direction. He becomes sinful person. Krishnadas Kaviraj, such a, so this is, we should not accept it as it is. This is humility. Tinadapi suni chena tarurapi sahishuna amanina mandena kirtaniyo sadai. This was the situation of Krishnadas Kaviraj, very humble personality, 24 hours Leela Chintan, always meditating on the pastime, confidential pastime of Brajavasi, Gopis and Krishna, Srimati Radharan and Krishna, chanting always name of Krishna and discussing sometimes with Raghunath Das Goswami, other charitra, character, Sri Upachatari Mahaprabhu. So today is his disappearance, and today is also disappearance of Raghunath Das Goswami. I was thinking to mention one incident about Raghunath Das Goswami. I will finish my presentation with that description. Raghunath Das Goswami also lived more than 40 years there in the bank of Radha Kund. And we are talking about eating habit. He was only eating one cup of buttermilk in 24 hours. Only his food was one cup, one glass of buttermilk. If needed, sometimes he used to put the ice rak, go gai ka rak, jala ka. This was his food. Everyone, it was known. In 24 hours, this much was his food. One glass of buttermilk, chhach matha. And he was doing his bhajan. One day he becomes seriously sick. Something got some trouble in his stomach, indigestion, heavy. So all the devotees immediately called one royal physician, a very expert Ayurvedic doctor. The doctor came and he touched the pulse of Raghunath Das Goswami. The touching pulse. He said that this is indigestion. Some food poisoning has taken place in the stomach. And this is due to excessive eating of sweet rice. Then all the Vaishnava, they say, you are pagal ho gaye ho kya? Foolish. So doctor said, he has excessive use of sweet rice. Only in 24 hours buttermilk, so that you say that he has eaten too much sweet rice, that reason why he is sick. He was very serious. He was expert. Then again he touched the pulse of Raghunath Das Goswami. And with all his confidence, no, it is due to excessive use, eating of sweet rice. And then he was very confident. With all confidence, thing. Then they become very beautiful. What is happening? They ask Raghunath Das, what is this? So he accepted, yes, yes. And night time, midnight, almost it was midnight, I consume. How come? Then in Manasi Chintan, Manasi Lila, he was thinking, sitting in the grove in one place in Kuti and thinking. So he prepared very क्या कहते हैं जो बहुत चीजें डालकर बनाते हैं प्रसादम opulent delicious and very heavy, difficult to digest, put many masala and this and that, what is one sweet rice, dry fruit, everything heavy. So he prepared mentally kasturi, all type of dry fruit and this and that, prepare in mind. And he offered Radha Krishna in mind, Mansi. And then Radha Krishna accepted. Even the Sakhi also partook. They also joined together and everyone. And still, it was, quantity was bigger. So remnant was also big quantity. Raghunatha said, that quantity I ate in mind. Everything was happening in sitting and there. Offering is done nicely, now remnant is there. Radha Krishna Prasadam is whatever remaining, since every Sakhi has taken, everyone completely satisfied, Lalita Abhisaka, everyone has. He could not throw that one, his Prasadam, so by thinking he ate everything. So, doctor was right, physician was right, he has eaten, but not. So by this incident we can understand that greatness, how they were connected with Krishna, how their bhakti was there. So today is a disappearance day of Raghunath Das Goswami and Raghunath Bhatt Goswami also and Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami. So I don't think we have any time. We still very any demanding comment or question, you are most welcome. Maharaj. Anything, give some comment.
You mentioned the three yukas and the different colors, white, red.
Yeah. And yellow. Of course, I was trying to read in 11th canto, this verse. Krishna Bhadam Tusa Krishnam Sango Pangasa Parsadam, there in the purport. Hridayananda Goswami, directly he has not given any his own commentary, just here Prabhupada, somewhere in Chaitanya Charan Prabhupada. So he has related that Hridayananda Goswami or disciple of Srila Prabhupada, they have. So Prabhupada commentary is there. He has given commentary. And when, to my surprise also came, the Asan Varnashtrayo Hyasya, your son, Gargacharya, your son, appears in every millennium, every four yuga, and his color is Sukla Raktas Tatha Pitam. And Idanim, this time, means Dwapar, he has assumed, he has accepted the blackish part. But other than this yuga, in Satya Yuga, white, in Treta, red, and in Kali Yuga, yellow. So Prabhupada talks about Sukla, another, not in that purport, Dehuti Putra, Kapil Dev complexion was and also Rakta, there two incarnations or Barah, boar incarnation. One word Swet Barah and Rakta Barah. And this appeared in the Treta Yuga, Barah. So that is considered to Manvantara avatar for that period. Though other incarnation also, Lord Ramchandra, even Lord Ramchandra appeared. About Lord Ramchandra, Treta Yuga, Srila Prabhupada in that purport talks about like a greenish blue, color of tota, parrot. And for Kali Yuga, appear clear. So Satya Yuga, white means Kapil Dev, red in Treta, red means Varah, one of Varah, white Varah also and red Varah, and Kali Yuga, yellow, clear. Granthra Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Srila Prabhupada ki. Yes.